And guys, for the month of April, drum roll! The month of April, I made a whooping sum of two. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be walking you through my 1 year journey on YouTube. I'm going to be explaining to you how the journey as a YouTuber has been so far. I know I'm still a small YouTuber, but it doesn't hurt to give a little analytics. And I feel this video is also meant for especially new YouTubers or people who are thinking to start a YouTube channel. This video, I'm creating it in a way to encourage people and also encourage myself. I clicked the record button for the first time April 25th, 2020, and then I published my first video that day. Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today I'll be making KFC chicken copied recipe. Just please watch, like, subscribe and share. You can also leave a comment below. If you want me to make any other food, just leave it in the comment section as well. Thank you. It's so funny, like, I can't believe it's 1 year already. And I remember starting this YouTube channel after I watched a YouTuber named Patricia Bright. I saw a video on her channel. Oh, I was scrolling through YouTube and then her video came. YouTube suggested her video. And the video I saw was how I made over $1 million on YouTube. I'm like, wait, people make money on YouTube? To be honest, I didn't know people actually made money on YouTube until I saw that video. So I watched the whole video and I'm like, oh my God. And then I'm like, okay, I'm going to start a YouTube channel, because she also in that video encouraged us to actually start the YouTube channel if you want to. That gave me the courage to start my YouTube channel. But then, am I going to advise someone to start a YouTube channel as well in 2021? My answer is going to be a yes. Even if maybe you're not starting a channel for the financial gain you can make from YouTube, I also think that there are a lot of things you can actually learn by being a YouTuber. Before starting YouTube, I didn't know what video editing was. I didn't know how to, you know, turn on a camera and talk to myself as if I'm talking to a lot of people. And then you go about scripting the video, editing the video, uploading the video, sharing the video, you know, coming up with video ideas and all of that. And creating content on YouTube has actually taught me a lot. And now if I go to watch videos on YouTube, I don't just watch it for entertainment purposes anymore. I just watch it to also learn from people, you know, especially YouTubers who now do it as full-time, to learn one or two from them and then try to incorporate it in mine as well. Because now YouTube alone is not just for fun as well. YouTube nowadays, people actually take it as full-time job. For me, is a passive income for now. I do not know what the future holds, but I enjoy making content. So now I'm going to be giving you some few things before I show you my analytics, how much I've actually made from YouTube, because I got monetized on January 6th. And so far, what that means is that YouTube starts placing ads on my video. And when you guys watch the ad, I get paid, you know, little money to support me to create great and amazing content for you guys. So what I would always advise people who want to start is, I know a lot of people, when they want to start, they're like, oh, I'm scared. Oh, nobody's going to watch me. Yes, it could be true. You could upload a video and you wouldn't have any views. But then you wouldn't know if you would have any views until you click and upload, until you create video and upload. So I would always want to encourage you that, yes, people are you're going to be shy. Maybe your family members might not support you and all of that. But just start. It's only when you start something that you can actually know if it's going to work out or not. Another thing I would want to tell people who are aspiring to be YouTubers or already creating content, even myself, is to learn what they call patience. For you to be able to grow in this space, you need, you know, normally we human beings, we have little patience, but for YouTube, you need to have an extra patience, because growing on YouTube can, it can be discouraging sometimes. You know, you put in a lot of effort to create amazing content and then you upload it, and maybe when you come back after a week or two, you see maybe like 10 views, 15 views. It can be very discouraging. But one thing about YouTube as well is to know that you have to be very, very consistent. And for you to be very, very consistent, it requires you to either maybe create content weekly, if you want to be creating content weekly, or if you want to create content once a month, just know that once a month, you have to upload something, consistency. But then, some people will tell you to have a particular schedule when you release a video. It doesn't really work for me because I have a full-time job, alright? So what I do is any little spare time I have, maybe in the evening after work or during weekends, I create video and edit them and then I upload them within the week. So I can't even make the promises of scheduling and maybe leaving a particular time to upload. So whenever opportunity comes for me to shoot, I just, go straight shoot and upload. And then also being in this financial niche, I can't put a schedule. So if something is trending, I have to go on quickly, read the update and immediately update you guys. So if I say I upload maybe every Monday, I might miss the information. Maybe it happened on Thursday and then I'm giving you the information the upper Monday. It will be very stale and might be very useless for you. But then there are other niches that can actually work with schedules. Another thing I would also want to tell you is when you're about to start, I know you will have that worry of, oh, I do not know the particular content to create. I do not have a niche. If you check my channel, you will see that I'm one of the most confused YouTubers there. But what I want to tell you is that it's very okay. When I started my channel, I started with cooking. It's not like I'm a great cook or I enjoy cooking, right? But it was just what I could shoot at that particular time. I started with cooking, but it wasn't sustainable for me. And I was like, okay, let me try and create something else. So if you're starting, do not be in a hurry to find your niche. Take your time and find something you enjoy, because this YouTube, like I mentioned, can be quite stressful and requires a lot of patience. So if you start it with something you don't really enjoy, you might be very discouraged along the way. So take your time to find your niche. I cooked, I did vlogs, I did all these games and challenges with my friends on YouTube. I even vlogged when I traveled to Dubai and all of that, because I have always loved money and I've always loved to teach people how to make money and talk about money. But it didn't really occur to me that, oh, your niche could be finance, until I started creating contents that were related to finance and I was enjoying it more. Not like I'm trying to restrict my channel on just finance based alone, but at least I know that more videos I'll be creating are going to be on finance. But I didn't just wake up and say, oh, my niche is just going to be on finance. If you're starting and you already know your niche, maybe you enjoy cooking, or like my friend Anne Marie, who has a channel and is all about beauty and lifestyle, this is something she has always known, very great. But if you do not have a niche, do not let it discourage you. And that thing too, people might say is, oh, I do not have a camera, I do not have good lighting. When I started, I started with my Samsung A50. I didn't have a tripod. I didn't even know what a tripod was until after posting my first video, I started researching on YouTube how to grow as a YouTuber and all of that. And I discovered that you could get a tripod, you could get the ring light and all of that. My first 8-9 videos were shot without tripod. So if you want to start, as long as you have a good phone, as long as you have a phone that can record, just record it and upload. And then with time, you're going to With each video, you're going to be learning one or two from it. And then another thing I would also want to tell you is, do not focus. I know a lot of people say do not focus on the numbers. It's actually very difficult not to focus on the numbers. But then I also want to tell you to not exactly focus on the numbers, because when you focus on the numbers, it could actually discourage you a whole lot to not want to continue. Imagine uploading maybe 15 or 20 videos and you have just maybe 10 to 20 subscribers. It can be very discouraging, but if you can try to, in a way, I know it's difficult, but try to, separate yourself as a normal person and also as a YouTuber. And then another thing I want to encourage when it comes to consistency is, why they always tell you to be consistent is, with consistency, you actually learn a lot. So if you, maybe every week, you upload, it will even teach you discipline, like, oh, I'm supposed to create this video and upload for these people. And when you consistently shoot, you know that things actually become easier for you. I know before, when I started creating, it took me then like 1 week to shoot a video and edit that video, but now I can shoot a video and edit it within 24 to 48 hours and upload. So because of how consistent I was, so now getting to being monetized on YouTube, it didn't actually happen overnight. I started creating content, like I said, April 25th, 2020. And then I relocated, I made a video. I think two of them got like some a lot of views and it gave me over 400 or 500 subscribers, but it was a struggle getting to the 1000. I didn't even know, or I know how it happened. I watched a video after making a video on my top 10 Netflix shows. Bridgerton was so interesting. I was like, okay, let me just make a compilation. Because, like I said, I didn't know what my niche was. I was like, let me make a compilation of this movie, of this series, and just upload. And then I uploaded it that night. Guys, the video took off. And up to now, I think now it has over 900,000 views. That was what actually got me to 1,000 subscribers. But the different part of it is that the subscribers I got from Bridgerton aren't they're not the niche or the people I'm looking for in terms of finance. Okay, so because I already created that Bridgerton compilation on my channel, people that subscribed were expecting maybe to see something related to that particular thing that I did. But then after that, when I uploaded the next video, the views were really, really small. All right, so what I just did was I continued the consistency. I continued to, you know, keep creating content, and then I started getting genuine followers that were following me for my finance content. So now, what does it mean to be monetized on YouTube? For you to be monetized on YouTube and to start making money, whereby YouTube will place ads on your video, you need two things. You need to meet two things, which is the 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours. 4,000 watch hours, guys. 4,000 watch hours. So I was able to meet the 4,000 watch hours and the 1,000 subscribers by January 4th. And then I applied for monetization. It took them 2 days to verify me because I didn't have the AdSense account, which is this. So when you create the account, when you create an AdSense account, which is what YouTube used to pay you, they're going to send you a PIN to verify your address and then ask you for account details, and that is how they would be paying you your, you know, what do I call it, monthly salary? Yeah, and how YouTube actually pays is they pay you, you know, your January salary, they pay it on, they've paid February, and then your February they pay March, like that. So they pay after 1 month. So now I'm going to take you into my studio to actually show you how my platform has been performing from when I started making videos on YouTube up to now, and how much YouTube has paid me so far. So I'm going to go into my studio, and if you look here, you can see that currently we have 4,587 subscribers. This is really amazing, guys, and I'm truly grateful. Like, thank you for all the support. So if you see here, you can see that for the last 28 days, I've had extra 1,918 subscribers. And I believe it was because I actually uploaded more content than I have ever done on this channel. I think I created over 12 contents the whole of April. And why that happened was because I had the Easter break, and then I also took 2 days leave. So it gave me time to create more contents. Another thing was I bought Studio Lightning, so I wasn't restricted to only shooting on Saturdays with daylight. I could actually wake up early in the morning, like around 6 a.m. or 4 a.m. or 5 a.m. to create videos, edit, and upload. And then if you look here, you can see that my watch hour for the last 28 days too is 7.6k hours. And then you can see the revenue here. So in the last 28 days, YouTube has I've made over $2,000. So now if you look here, the last video performance, so for every video you upload on YouTube is going to be showing you analytics of how that video has been performing. So it means that this video ranked fourth for the last 10 videos I've uploaded. It means that this video is not performing so badly, and then the click-through rate, which is when people see it and click on it, is 7.4%, which is not so bad. So now I'm going to take you into the full analytics to show you everything. So when we get to this full analysis, you'll see YouTube telling me, congrats, more people discovered your video from sources outside of YouTube in the last 28 days. And then it's showing me here that in the last 28 days, I've gotten over 129,000 views. And then I have 7,600 watch hours. And I also have 1,900 subscribers as well. And this last month, I've been able to make $2,085. So now I'm going to take you more into the revenue, because that's like the sweet part, and I'm going to be explaining some things to you. So when you come to revenue here, you can see what we call the CPM and the RPM. So how you actually get your estimated revenue on YouTube is what we call, we have the CPM, and the CPM is how much advertisers are willing to pay per 1,000 views. So if you have 1,000 views for a particular video, advertisers have how much they want to pay YouTube for that. And then YouTube now remits, which is what we call the RPM, which is revenue per mile. So if the advertisers pay YouTube $33 per 1,000 view, for example, they are going to be giving me $16.25 for that 1,000 view. So YouTube takes their cut, and then this RPM is my personal, what I actually take home. So now you can see that here, each month, for the first month when I got monetized, January, what I made was $25. Then this RPM, guys, I always tell people that it's like CGPA in school. You have to build it up. Or for me, I had to build it up. So if we come to the month of, say, for example, let me customize it, and we come to the month of January, right? So if we come to the month of January, let me fix this. And then we do 31st. Do one. Sorry. Yeah, so you can see that the month of January, right? My CPM was $12 and my RPM was 0. It was 4 cents, guys. Very little. So I had to, I think the more I uploaded videos and the more people were coming on my channel, this RPM kept on increasing. So you can see that the whole month of January, I made a whooping sum of $25. And then if we come to the month of February, you can see that in the month of February, it increased from 4 cents to 11 cents. But then I made lower money. So one thing about YouTube is you get paid per the type of content you create. There are some contents that have higher RPM and there are some contents that have lower RPM. So in the month of February, I actually made videos that were related mostly to vlogs, and they didn't really have, because that was when I was on vacation, I was in Dubai then, and they didn't really have high RPM. So, and people also did not have a lot of views, because for you to make this money, you need to have more views for YouTube to place ads on your videos, and when people watch it, you make money, right? So the month of February, I made lesser than I made in the month of January, which was $12. It was a little bit discouraging, but I'm like, well, I've already started making passive income from it, why not, you know, put in more effort? And then in the month of March, right, if it comes to the month of March, this RPM grew from $5, from 11 cents to $5.81, and I made a whooping sum of $572. Guys, this was really massive, because I'm like, are you serious? People can actually make, although I used to watch people that make, that do videos like this, how much they make from YouTube, I didn't believe I could make up to $500 a month as a small YouTuber, to be honest. So if you check, you can see that some days I was making 9 cents, 47 cents, 14 cents. Like, the money was really low until one day I made $8. I'm like, I made $8 from YouTube. Are you kidding me? I'm like, oh, so this is good. And then the next day it went down to $4. And then it kept on reducing to like 15 cents again. And then I released the Safe Moon video. The first day I saw $30. I'm like, wait. And then I saw $86. I'm like, And then the next day, guys, I saw $128. I'm like, wait. I am rich! $128 a day from YouTube. It was really mind-blowing, guys. So at the end of it all, I made $572. And then we came to the month of April. I'm like, okay. So because I released more videos in the month of March, and with that, I had the opportunity to, you know, drive more people to my channel. I'm going to see if I could maximize my holidays and make more videos to see what would happen. And then I'm a believer of asking God for something. I'm like, God, so since I've been able to make this $572, I want to make $1,000. And guys, for the month of April, mind blowing. Drum roll. The month of April, I made a whooping sum of 2,000. Okay, although this is, I'm shooting this video April 30th. They've not paid for day 20. They've not paid for 29th and 30th. So I can't really add, but so far I know it would enter 2,100 and something. But my RPM grew to $16. I made $2,097, and my CPM increased to $33. So in the month of April, which is my highest so far, I've made $2,000. So if we now check so far on YouTube since I got monetized, which is so if we do this, you can see that I have made a total of $2,708 4 months being monetized on YouTube. And then my RPM, so because I stay really really low, I think they took the average, and my RPM is $2.42, and then my playback is $32. So this is just to encourage you guys that if you're looking for a way to make passive income, I know the journey can be quite long, but then good things, they say, take time. So it's going to take time. I know I'm aspiring to, you know, hit 100,000 subscribers, 200, 500,000, even 1 million subscribers. And I know that one day I will get there, but it's slow and steady. As long as I keep giving you guys valuable contents, which I promise I will do. And that thing that helps me too is if you're looking to be a YouTuber, I'm going to share a template. My friend Gift Egwenu gave me this template where she, you know, I'm going to link her channel the description, because she had a video where she explained how she uses Notion to organize her life. And as a friend, you know, she showed me this and I'm like, oh my god, I really need to have this. So this helps me plan my videos. So one thing about being a YouTuber is not like it's compulsory, but it helps you not to, you know, get really discouraged, to plan out how, you know, the videos you want to shoot. As you can see here, I have the to-do, like things I want to do on my channel. I have the planning, I have the scripting, editing, and when I publish, you see this, you see it here. So for the month, which this one I'm currently shooting the YouTube journey analytics, and then tomorrow I'll be shooting plan with me. So I've already scripted out, like written out things that I want to shoot for the month of May. So this is also another thing that helps me, and I hope with this video I'm able to encourage you that if you've been looking to start a channel on YouTube, and maybe you already even started and it's looking like, you know, it's taking forever, just hang in there. I'm telling you, hang in there. I know that, I mean, I even sometimes get scared that, oh, maybe it's just this month that it will do well, and another month it may not do well, but it, all those thoughts can come. But all I just keep telling myself is, keep creating good content, and one day the YouTube algorithm is going to smile at you. So thank you guys also for people who watch my ads. Thank you so much for, you know, listening to me. I know sometimes I usually have imposter syndrome, like, am I worthy to create this content? But then you never know. And then the nice comments you guys leave on my channel really keeps me going. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for listening to me ramble and rant about YouTube. But I would want to encourage you, just start. You never know if you would succeed until you start. Just start something, guys. If you're looking to start and you're discouraged, you do not know where to start, start with YouTuber tag. Oh, this is me, welcome to my channel, this is what I like to do. I do not have any idea what I'll be creating on this channel, but I just want to start. Let's just start, because I know if I didn't start when Patricia Bright told us to start, you know, I don't think I would be here today. I know I still struggle. I have a lot to learn when it comes to video editing, scripting out better content, quality videos, you know, and all of that. So it just helps, because this money now helped me purchase some of these lights I'm using, the camera, and all. I even want to get like a personal laptop, because my personal laptop here is very dusty. Like, the thing has almost packed up, and I want to get, you know, a better one. So it's the money I make from YouTube that I also reinvest to, you know, create better content. This video is getting too long, guys. Sorry. So thank you. I'm going to create another video on things that I have learned so far on YouTube, and, you know, how you can grow. I'm still learning to grow, but some of the few things I've picked up along the way, I'm going to be making video on that. Even how I edit my videos and plan my videos and shoot my videos, script them and upload, all of that I'm going to do in a very different video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope this video did not make you feel some type of way, but encouraged you, you know, to hang in there or hit the high road by clicking start. Bye guys.